Hey guys, how are you? Hope you're all well. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to have another look at Krusty, the saw we put together and called a 4-cube race saw, although I don't really get out and race, but whatever, it is what it is. Just for fun, just to kind of compete with myself and see how fast I could make the saw. But originally I'd tried a 395 carb, two different ones. They were aftermarket junk, never could get one of them to run right, and ended up putting just one of the Farmer Tech, what they call the Walbro carburetors. It looked like a Walbro. I don't know that it was, but it was more expensive than their normal carburetor. But saw picked up something like 25% in the cut with that, and saw's pretty fast for what it is. It's a 365 special top end, like some busted up, mismatched cases. I think the clutch side case half's a 365. Flywheel side case half's a 2171. Both came out of my junk bin. Both have chips and places busted off of them. It's got a 2171 crank in it that the flywheel threads were very questionable on. It's on there and secure, but it was in the junk pile. Saw does have brand new bearings, new seals, case gasket, OEM flywheel, OEM clutch. One of the problems I was having before was the Farmer Tech clutches just wasn't fitting it right for some reason, but I did order a little more high-end clutch and put that on it, or clutch drum rather, and got the slack taken up out of that. What else? It's got a broken up 365 handle. What else? Farmer Tech muffler. It's got a Duke's Molly coated 365 special 48 millimeter piston. Does have a pop-up cut into it. It's got a 365 special cylinder OEM. A ton of machine work. It was actually the first cylinder that I ever machined. A lot of that machine work was done to me not knowing what I was doing and screwing up in the beginning, but kind of slowly figuring things out. And we'll just say she's got a paper thin base now, but she goes down on saw nice and true. But I'm thinking there was about 70 thou cut out of the combustion chamber with the pop-up. Saw has a pretty high exhaust roof and still has over 200 psi of compression, so that tells you how much machine work and, you know, the deal with the pop-up with it as well. Very little transfer work. I don't think I touched the intake much. Might have widened it, but just some simple stuff, you know, go fast stuff. But I'm sure somebody that knows how to build a race saw could actually get it and take it even further. But anyway, what we have today is I've got a X-Torque carburetor. I've de-choked it, and I just found out today that those have a divider in them. I'd never really paid attention and looked in the carb. Any one I've tried to put on like an, what some people call an OE, but just an original 372 when doing the swap, or 365 or anything, I just never could get it to run right on top end. It just seemed like there wasn't enough fuel for what amount of air was going through it, and I honestly think that divider could be the reason. It could go nuts and not run at all without that, but we're going to find out. I've got a velocity stack I'd made in the lathe a while back. We're going to put that on it as well and see if we can get a bar and chain rounded up and a piece of wood, and maybe get out and make some cuts with it and see how she goes.
A look at this saw. I was told by one of you guys that this was the ugliest saw you'd ever seen. Well, buddy, I hate to tell you, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. I love that old saw. It ain't old, most of it's new, apart from some busted up, worn out parts. And I didn't mention the big muffler mod. I'd originally put like a 1-inch is a 1-inch ID pipe into that. Not OD, but ID. The inside diameter of it was an inch. I think the outside diameter was 1.25 inches or something, but it was big. And that's when we had those other carbs on it, so I done away with that. And that is actually a deflector off of a 394 XP muffler that I pulled off of a saw that was kind of smashed when we got it here. But here's what we're going with. And for some reason I can't get real close this camera, but maybe you can see the little notches in there. There was like a plastic divider. I just took some needle nose, went in, and broke that mess out, and hopefully didn't destroy a good carburetor. If so, whatever, but I don't think we did. If it does act up, probably just throw the choke back in it, which I have. Won't be an issue, but enough around on my jaw. See if we get a flat screwdriver. Start disassembling this thing. I actually have a 372 over here that we're going to tear down and maybe do a complete build on if I have a good case half to go on it. It's actually like a 2166 bottom end, I think, but the bridge that goes across here is broke out of it, and I'm wanting to kind of make a nice saw out of it. Kind of got ahead of myself there a little bit. This saw's fully functional, air filter, everything. Can't have a race saw that way. And like I said, I don't even race. Aftermarket clips don't want to come loose, guys. Set all this over here in a cart because we're not putting that back on it. I actually have a complete 365 that I've actually dyed all the plastic on. We'll be using aftermarket top plastic, but I've got like OEM hand-on tank assembly. I've got like a mint set of 2165 cases. OEM crankshaft, flywheel. A lot of good parts. Nice OEM top end. I think the only thing I'm going to have to pick up is a piston. And there's no need in me putting those in that tight, but as soon as I don't, they vibrate out. A lot of nice parts. Need to get on that. I've got a nice 365 we completely restored. It's basically about a complete OE saw. Nice saw, full wrap, big dogs on it. It is the one that we done that. What was it? Hogged out transfers versus machine work. Some of you guys loved it, but trust me, there was some people hated that. And it was actually, this cylinder was on another saw that I've sold since then. I've sold a lot of saws over the last couple years, probably 20 or more. Sold a handful this year alone, probably half a dozen or so, and need to sell more. Can't keep all these dang things. Hell, I'd sell this once it's done. I'd pull it apart and get a good laugh out of it. Might be worth that to someone. I'm real confident in myself, as you can tell. We don't want to lose them damn things. I don't even know that you can get those aftermarket, those little tubes. I think I have two here in my parts bin somewhere, but you absolutely do not want to lose those. I'll tell you what I'm going to do with them. I'm going to drop them in that cup along with a choke rod. Probably that carburetor when we get it off. But what we have to do is, you can see this throttle cable's probably wore completely out because I've got a damn zip tie around it. And I'm sure that camera is picking that up. Someone's laughing at that because they've done that same shit before. I'll guarantee it, if you fooled with these saws, that cable, and I've drained the fuel out of that, but I still don't want any fuel loaders over here in this shop. I've had them already, and man, that Chinese fuel line just don't want to give up the ghost, does it? It sticks on there when you put it on. Only the finest here in my shop. I ain't no problem with that Farmer Tech line. It gets a little hard, but it ain't bad. It ain't wanting to come off that carburetor either. Should edit that shit out. I will if it's too long when I get into the editor. And that's one we want on there good. Don't abuse your body like that, guys. See, that's one of their marked Walbro carburetors. I don't know, it looks just like one, and that thing starts easy even on that saw. So, and they're always out of stock, so somebody likes them. I always end up having to order the other carburetor, and it's like a, you know, a hit or miss whether that thing's any good or not. Their tub of parts, put that carburetor right in it, and 6 months from now when I need it, I'll be wondering where in the hell that carburetor's at. Now that's a build I need to get onto next, because I need to put together a saw that I can sell kind of cheap. And looks like we've got that turned up right where we need it. Maybe I'm going to screw around and get you guys all out of whack here. I don't guess it matters anyway. We'll just loosen up a clamp. And I knew that was Phillips head. I knew it. That one might be too big. Nah, just right size. The main reason for this is I've got to spin things around. I was going to use that X-Torque flange, but there's no reason we can't just spin. No, I'd rather use that on something else. Let's just put that in our tray with our carburetor and use the X-Torque flange. It's plastic, but it's a pretty heavy plastic. I don't care a bit to use it. So we need to loosen that up enough to spin the boot around. That might be sufficient. Try that. See what happens. Okay, guys, so the X-Torque flange can be used with this. Normally, they'll have like little, I'm going to call them little tits sticking up. What I do is just go in and trim those out. It's a done deal. You can put it right on without a hiccup. I'm trying to look through the monitor there and see what's going on. And I've got an OS's and OE boot. They're original. It even looks like an OEM one I've dug out. About sure it is. And what I'm going to do right now, before I do much of anything, is just mock this up before we get the V-stack out and put in. And see how close we're going to be to setting Hellfest level. If you notice, I've not got the ring or anything in. That one's in. I think that one started. So, I think right there, if we tighten that clamp back down, we'll set fairly level. Level enough to work anyway. Hold pressure against that clamp so I can torque it down. Dang sure don't want it to come loose. That's not going to be the best screwdriver for that application. Let's try that one. It's a touch smaller. There we go. Work down now. Your average person, it was probably tight enough with the other one, but just me. So now let me dig around, get the V stack out, and we'll get that swapped on. Okay, so the X torque bolts are way too long to use the stack that I made, because when I done it, I'd countersunk the holes, you know, where it would have a good clean look. So yeah, we had to get the other bolts back out. Honestly, when I put it back together this way, I had some problems. I had to countersink the holes deeper in the stack for the bolts. I kind of wondered about that when I made it anyway, but I did go back to the metal flange because I went back to the other bolts. Both use the same bolts, but it's like, whatever, what the hell, we'll just put the new metal flange on it. But by doing that, I don't have to have the dang zip tie on it now. With the zip tie, it wasn't returning the idle, but we'll get over here in another shop, I'll button it on up and fuel it up and probably have to choke it to paper towel or something and see if this thing will bust off and run. Ain't she gorgeous? Ain't she a beaut, Clark? Take out that choke. Somebody's going, why are you doing that to that saw? Because I can, it was all a bunch of junk. It's still a bunch of junk, but it's my junk. And I'm gonna end up smacking the hell out of my hand on that, I bet. Nope, I think we got a pot, I don't know. Maybe not. Let's just give it a drink. It may want more fuel than it was wanting on the other saw, due to there not being a choke mechanism. That's what I'm talking about. Now we'll choke it. I actually seen John Riley doing that. I comment on his stuff, but I don't even know if he knows who I am. I think we're flooded now. Find a screwdriver to tune it with. Brief intermission.
I'm starting to think those export carburetors are just not jetted very well at all, because on any ported saw I've had one of these on, they just kind of act about the same, just like I ain't getting enough fuel, but it's sounding pretty good starting these. That's probably every bit of 16 grams, so it's a zinging up there pretty good. I'm about afraid to stand over top of the damn thing, free revving it. I'm gonna try to see if I can get a bar and chain set up. The 257's got the chain on it. I normally run on that. We may just do some swapping around here and get something done. Either that chain's do a touch up on one side, or it's got to do with that handle being broke. You can feel it just revving the saw, and when it goes in the cut, you can feel it. I like took epoxy and fiberglass and kind of patched that handle back up, and I'm talking the whole tank assembly on the bottom, but yeah, you can still feel it, but holy crooked cuts, about all I can say. Yeah, if you was really wanting to race with it, I'm thinking maybe one of those skid plates. You know, bolt it to the front of the handle, secure it to the back, somehow might stiffen it up a lot, or we may take another video and pull it down and try to stiffen it up a little more. I don't really want to put a new aftermarket one on it, because it kind of goes against the build, I guess, but we could just for the hell of it, I guess, but, boy, she pulls, she screams too. I don't know, that chain seems to be pulling a big old chip, but man, that last cut I cut was really, really crooked, like, not really rainbow down, but crooked to the side crooked. Seems to be idling good. I've got to idle a little rich, and I could fatten it up a little bit on top, but it seems that's what this build wants, is to scream. There's still decent blubber up there real high, but yeah. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. The title's clickbaity. Well, so be it. It's a racer, but I don't really race, or haven't yet. Who knows what the future will hold, but my wife's trying to get me to get out and do more, but I just don't do good around big crowds. Never have, never will. You know, it is what it is. But anyway, guys, with that said, old Krusty, pray that the bar and chain took off and fuel drained and set back on the shelf till I decide to pull it out and fool with it again, but that piece of wood's about, I don't know, 10 inches or so. I've not went back there and measured it. Ain't going to, but you can probably tell by its 16-inch bar how big it is, or if it even really matters, but it's good sound wood, good to do testing in. But anyway, guys, y'all have a good one.